Let's talk about Apple's big announcement yesterday. In case you haven't already heard, Apple made a big transition moving from the Intel chips to Apple's own silicon that they've been using in their iPhone and iPads. And the first Mac with this new processor will be shipped
by the end of this year, and we expect the transition to take about 2 years.
However, I actually think they'll be able to do it sooner, because when Apple moved from PowerPC to Intel back in 2005, they also made the same 2-year estimate, but they were actually able to do it in 1 year. So Apple did demos at the conference showing the capabilities of the new Apple processor, and they put the A12Z chip, which you can find in their latest iPad Pro, and they stuck that exact chip in a Mac Mini little small desktop computer. And one of the highlights from that was that this small computer was capable of doing video editing 3 streams of 4K ProRes video. That is really impressive, but that's not what's interesting to me. What has me really excited about these processors are their graphics performance. So if what we're led to believe is true and all the demos were done on that Mac Mini, one of the really interesting demos was Shadow of the Tomb Raider, which was being emulated for an Intel processor.
You can see the game is responsive, it's smooth, and the best part is we're running it at 1080p as it translated up under emulation. So these new Macs, they are fast. You can see some more of the lighting effects here.
Now that's important because the current Intel Mac Mini currently being sold cannot play that game or any other type of game very similar to that with those graphic settings because it has Intel graphics.
Alright, so it's around 15 to 20 frames a second. Probably 15. And it's low graphics, it's not impressive. But, you know, Mac Mini.
And from this demo, apparently there was no external graphics card. I don't even think external graphics cards would work with emulation. And even with a hand tied behind its back because it was emulating, you know, the Intel architecture, it could run that game at 1080p on pretty high settings. I mean, the game looked really good. So that's made me very excited about the graphics performance of these new Apple processors, because for the longest time, Apple has always struggled with graphics a little bit. And if it can give really good graphics performance on a small chip, that's going to be key for both their laptops and their smaller desktop computers like the Mac Mini. And again, to re-emphasize it, it's basically an unmodified iPad processor put in this computer. So it's only 7 watts power, so it's really power efficient. It's passively cooled. There's no fans for an iPad Pro, obviously. And it's able to give you all that performance. That's made me really excited when it comes to apps and games that are developed specifically for that processor that don't have to be emulated if the performance is that good during emulation. I'm also very excited to see what the specific new Mac chips look like. Obviously, they're not going to ship an A12Z. You know, it's very similar to 2005 when Apple, you know, moved to Intel and they did Pentium 4 under development kits, but the actual Macs that they sold were Core Duos. Macs have a lot more thermal room than an iPad, and they also have a lot more RAM. So I'm really excited to see what those processors look like to optimize all that, because not only do I want faster performance, but I also want better battery life. For years, MacBooks have hit like a battery limit of 10 hours, and that's best case scenario for like a MacBook Air. Typically get half of that, if not a third of that, if you're using a MacBook Pro. So not only do I want a faster computer so I can get my work done faster, and therefore I'd save battery in general, but if you actually have extra battery life to give you some extra breathing room, that's only a benefit for absolutely everyone, right? So that's what has me excited about the chips, but leave a comment below on what you think Apple can bring to their own chips to the new Mac lineup. I also think this is Apple's best chance to actually bring more games to the Mac platform, because Apple obviously has it in the bag when it comes to mobile gaming. I mean, the iPhone is the most popular mobile gaming device. So when you think about a company like Epic, who makes Fortnite, you know, they obviously have different code bases for their Mac version and their iOS version. But now, because we're all using the same processors, they can essentially have one version of Fortnite compiled for both the Mac, the iPad, and the iPhone, which means when they want to update it and add new features, it's super easy for them to push it all across at once. And it's also very similar for games that are just made for Mac, so something like Shadow of the Tomb Raider. If they decide to move to the Apple processor, you know, now they can easily compile a version for the iPad Pro. Since we both know it runs really well on the A12Z chip, you know, it's much easier for them to do cross-platform development for these different types of Apple devices. This basically means that if you're a game developer, the question really isn't about the market size of just the Mac anymore. If they decide to port a game over, they can essentially port it to all platforms. Now, Apple would have to make a change to their App Store policy to allow these types of games to be up there, but they would require a games controller. But that's probably something they should do. And also, you can also bring the Apple TV into that, because the Apple TV also uses those chips. And obviously, playing games on a big screen TV is the obvious next step. Now, the Apple TVs do need more storage. 64 gigabytes is not a lot for these big games, but it's obviously something they can do in the future. Now, Apple says they're going to release their first Mac with the new processor by the end of the year. But specifically, I think that means obviously in the autumn when macOS Big Sur is released. Big Sur is their new version of the macOS operating system. And after 20 years, we're finally saying goodbye to macOS 10, as this is the first version being macOS 11. I actually think Apple's probably going to drop the point increments that we've had for 20 years. So don't be surprised if the new Mac operating system next year is macOS 12. Apple completely redesigned the user interface, icons, and sounds. And what everybody has noticed is that these things are much bigger, and therefore they're more touchscreen friendly. I can't assume we'll see touchscreen Macs, but if Apple is bringing iPhone and iPad apps to the Mac for the first time with these new processors, you know, controlling an iPhone app with your, you know, your touchpad or your mouse is not going to be a pleasant experience. It never was on Windows, and iOS doesn't have a secret sauce. So to me, a touchscreen Mac would be the most practical way you could have those apps on the Mac platform. Although, I mean, it could be anything. It could be just, you know, extra features for Sidecar for the iPad. It could be bringing Sidecar to the iPhone. We don't exactly know just yet. So I'm personally really excited and hyped for these new Apple processor Macs. The Mac has been boring for the past few years, and I think that's going to add a lot of energy into it. I recommend no one buy a new Mac computer, even though they said they plan to still sell new Mac computers with Intel chips throughout the year. Just wait if possible. Thankfully, with my computer workflow, I'm pretty good to jump from day one, I must say. I'm pretty careful with what apps I put into my workflow. I try to use a lot of web services if possible. And Microsoft and Adobe have announced that obviously Microsoft Word and the Adobe Creative Suite will be available day one on these new Apple processors. So, you know, I have Excel and After Effects. I'm basically ready to go. And obviously having Final Cut Pro is obviously a huge part of that. I was really considering changing my Mac computer from a laptop to a desktop, like a Mac Mini or an iMac, as my work has changed and my needs have evolved. But honestly, if the performance gains are really good on these new Apple processors, I'll probably keep and get just a new MacBook. But you know, that's how dire things were with these Intel Macs, that like I actually had to actively consider whether I need to change my workflow from being a, you know, a mobile system to more of a desktop system. But leave a comment below and let me know what you're excited about or what has you nervous and questioning the transition. I'd love to have a conversation about this, mostly because it's all we can do until we see what the first ARM Mac looks like. I also just want to say thank you to all my new subscribers. My channel has grown a double over the past month, and I know a lot of you really enjoyed the Surface Go 2 coverage. I'm trying to like research what the next product I bring in and review is, but I really appreciate the support, and the channel has just crossed 50,000 views, which I'm super excited about. But if you liked this video and you want to see more videos like this, please subscribe and hit the notification bell to stay tuned, and I will see you all in my next video. Bye. Thank you.